Hello, my dear viewers. It's time for Battle for Mewni part 2, I would say. This is actually episode 2 of season 3. Yeah, I guess so. Okay, let's start this. Hello, if you don't know me, my name is Andy, and if you're not subscribed to me, you can hit the subscribe button, but please also the little bell, even if you're already subscribed, hit the bell so you don't miss any videos of mine. And you see, if all the patrons who are waiting for content that is especially early for you, this Battle for Mewni thing, okay, I will make this, I won't bring this out earlier for you. I will, because it's already a little bit old right now, and I at first refused to make a reaction, so I don't want to bring it out for the whole public even more later than that's already the case. So, but the next thing after this, I will definitely bring out first for you guys. So, if you're wanting to watch many of my videos earlier than other people, there's also a Patreon in the description, but now let's roll. 3, 2, 1, and go. And if you don't know me, my name is Andy. I'm from Germany, and I'm living in the capital of Germany, Berlin. And it's getting a little bit weird. Dimension. Had a good time, bang out. Woohoo! I'm having fun with the series. I don't really like this special very much, but maybe the future is bright, so I will try to enjoy this as much as I can, even though I already watch it and I'm not very fond of it. I like moments of it. But now let's start. Hey, so we are with Ludo after the events of season 2. Tuck House. Ah, the bird is back. He was sent to the tacos, to the Earth dimension, where a taco supplier was. Oh, that's nice. They take care of him. That's kind of nice, considering they were once enemies. Yeah, you're back at the temple. Oh. I hope you can see. Yeah, you can. I thought maybe they can't see the picture. Ah, yeah, the wand's part of you now.
Wand?
Try to.
Wand?
Yeah.
I have a wand. Hand.
Yeah, you do.
I don't know if I like this.
This special, wait, I don't know if I like this.
Wait!
I don't like this.
Where's Glossary? No.
Making
here,
jokes.
I'm right where you left me.
Yeah, Glossary, hey. I love this character, by the way.
Glossary! Oh, Glossary! They turned my hand into a wand, and you into a pole.
Mm-hmm. I am.
Yeah, that
not
happened.
Not. I'm over here.
he's so stupid sometimes, Ludo.
Where have you been?
What do you mean? Where have I been? You told me to hide. I hid. Oh, come on.
What? I never told you to hide.
Wait, now. Which one of you am I talking to right now?
Which one? It's me, Ludo!
Oh, yes, it's you. Yeah, all right, never mind.
What's going on? Who trashed my house?
You did.
What?
You defeated the Magic High Commission.
I did?
Well, not
yeah,
you.
Yeah, not you, yeah. Exactly. It was Toffee.
I defeated the Magic High Commission.
Yeah, of course he doesn't listen.
I can't believe
Ludo,
it.
Please. Oh. Get
this
a grip.
To be a chapter in the book of spells, then
you think so high of
how
you.
Powerful I am.
But inside, you know, you're not that strong. Sorry, it wasn't necessary.
What? The butterfly castle? Oh no no no! First, I write my chapter in the book. Then I'll
Ludo wants to go to the castle.
Where was I? There we go.
Ouch.
That's not going to work, you see.
Didn't that hurt?
Only the owner can write in the book of spells.
You! Glossary.
Okay.
Should I write my normal handwriting?
I should call him Groserick.
What should I call my chapter?
He's pretty Ludo gross sometimes.
Ludo, the better than everyone else. I like the sound of that.
Yeah, everybody likes the sound of that, including their name. Problem, but no, no it's problem. Not rea- the reality.
I told you, it's not your book anymore.
Okay. Maybe it just needs a little space. Yes, that's it. I'll just come back some other time.
No. Okay, now we come to a part which I don't like. Because this him trying to write in that book, for the it is not very important to the whole plot, and it takes so much time. I mean, okay, they were thinking let's put a little slapstick in here and play with this, but clearly it goes on for far too long until he gets like
one of my favorite things that's happened to me,
like just destroys the book. Later on, Glosseric says it's just a book, but let's be honest, it seems a little bit like it has its own life sometimes, like in the last shot. And what's he doing? He's trying to heat pudding up.
You will let me write in you!
Yeah, it's a no. Your friend zone.
I hurt in places I didn't know I had.
I don't know if I should feel embarrassed for this joke or not, but I don't care if I should. If you think I should.
Oh, give me a break.
A spell, of course. Why didn't I think of this before?
Because you are stupid. I do like this character, but this naivety and stupidity is sometimes a little bit too exaggerated for my taste. And this, if I remember correctly, is quite weird, but very funny in a way.
Where am I?
Oh, yeah,
thanks, Marion. That's so nice.
That's it.
Barbara, my favorite. Oh, that really hits the spot. Say. You got any of those tiny
this may seem like a silly knees? Joke, but I actually like that scene because it tells us something interesting about this character.
Funny. I know this is a bit low.
I will tell you in a second.
But I can't remember how I got here.
This is kind of creepy in a weird way, the scene. And funny, yes. And the fish have legs! Help! Okay, I get it. Man, and then fish legs, fish having human legs. Okay, get it. Get the joke. Yeah, and this is what I mean, because we see here that he could be happy if he wouldn't be concentrated all the time at something he wants, you know? If he wouldn't I don't know the right English here. If you wouldn't be too much into getting something special that he really, really wants.
Yes, well that's
if he wouldn't focus on that so much, he would be already happy. And that's actually what he wants to be. He wants to find peace and happiness.
That's it.
On the long run.
That doesn't make any sense. I took it. It's right there. How can it not be mine?
I don't know. Why don't you ask the book?
Why don't you just tell him, Glosseric?
No.
Glosseric is in the special, especially like, fuck it, I don't tell anybody anything, not even the star.
Look, I demand that you let me write in you this instant, or I'll turn this car around so fast, it'll make your head spin.
Now this last scene here, where this book thing comes to a conclusion, is actually
sorry,
not bad.
Okay? I'm sorry. It's just
it's a little, I think,
I
commentary even
you won't give
on,
it to me. And I want it so much. You and I aren't really
human interactions,
you know? Both like magic
relationships.
And, other stuff. What I'm trying to say is I really appreciate...
This could be a very honest conversation between two lovers.
Don't let me write in you because of something I did or I said or I
with a little bit other words, right. Different words.
I'm just going to come right out and say it. I love you, Book.
Yeah, I actually love you because I want something from you.
I'd be honored if you let me write in you.
Glossary's reaction, of course, is hilarious.
I'm sorry. It's a book. You cannot talk to the book.
And here again, he said he doesn't have any emotions. Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, never mind.
Glossary, things make you cry, things make you laugh. Of course you've got emotions, you're a fucking liar.
Funny that I ever believed.
I really believed that for a while, that he doesn't have any emotions.
Wants
but
to be a mighty, magical superstar. What a joke, right? Ha ha ha, joke on me.
Well, maybe if you just stop wanting something to be something you're not.
Your cute little sparkles on the cheeks. I'm just a sad little dingus in a chip bag.
Ah, okay. Now, of course, we have the self-pity number here going on.
Well, if you don't want me in your book, then I don't want me in it either!
Not a fan of people go like this. It doesn't go anywhere. And it's basically just another way to try to get what you want in the end. What else is it?
Well, Duffy,
oh, this is cool. He's Duffy again.
You got him to do what you wanted.
I didn't want this. This was all Ludo. But now that you're gone, I can finally get him to do what I wanted. I'd love to chat more, but it looks like you're out of time.
An interesting thing here.
You know, even though I knew this was coming, it's a...
Look at his stuck kind of pudding now. It glows.
Hey, look! It worked!
You know what he's doing here? I didn't get it when I watched it the first time, but now I know. He's saving some magic. And this is exactly the magic that...
No! Glossary! What have I done? I'm sorry!
That Star uses later on and becomes the butterfly and defeats Toffee. Oh, okay, now I actually have a little bit pity for him in that second.
You mean it's for the best?
Yeah, don't listen to your hand.
Right. The book was a distraction. We don't need it anymore. We don't need anyone anymore. Butterfly Castle, I'm coming for you.
Okay, if you must. Sorry again for the non-stop advertisement in the bottom for DuckTales. I can't not put it away. I would have to crop some part of the image and I don't want to do that. I do like River, but the King is such a weird character. I mean, he's likable sometimes, but also sometimes... He's also too childish to really like. I mean, to get fully into that character for me. He kind of reminds me of Ludo a little bit, just that he actually became king and is beloved by many people and stuff. So it does kind of fit that he has the same voice actor than Ludo. If you didn't find out yet, then just listen closely. You will hear that from now on. That's the same voice actor that voices Ludo. And he's great. He also voiced... his voice was also in Frozen. And Wreck-It Ralph. There he was King Candy. Or actually the villain. I don't want to spoil that movie for you. It's a great movie. Looking up to the next installment and to the number 2 sequel. I mean, I don't know what I could say about this. I was happy to see Rubarian back, but the King is just a little bit childish here. He's just like, oh fuck it, I wanna party all night, all day. And it's understandable. We find out later why he does that, but.
Can someone come and fix my thing?
The thing is, his younger version seemed much more intelligent than this he turned out to be, you know? It's kind of sad if you see him like this and then and saw his earlier self.
Ha, my music thing isn't working. I need you to take a look at it.
Where's my monkey?
Oh, that was your monkey. Can't say that I've seen him. Not to be rude, but there are more pressing matters, you see.
Star?
Marco uses its gizzards, finally.
This place is a mess.
Marco!
Why didn't you think of this sooner, Marco? Really?
Marco, my boy! I can't believe you're here! Have you seen Fool Duke's monkey?
No.
How could he have?
Eye out. I threw him. What's this?
Well, they were Captain Blanche's sugar seeds. It's, Star's favorite cereal. You can't get them on Mewni, so I brought her a box.
Marco, you're not giving that to my daughter. It's all smashed. Probably a good thing.
Because of you, you idiot. Yeah, there are some. I basically like the king, but this. I really hate this episode. Okay, I have to say it because I think this episode is totally boring. It has nothing of interest for me, almost nothing, except Marcus using his kisses finally.
She and her mother just took a little trip.
And okay, the joke later on with the monster is a little bit funny. Okay, I give it that. But other than that, this is really just, I'm just literally just sitting this out so to get to the next episode, which is much better than this one.
What I mean is, morale doesn't.
And this episode has some parts where I really am like this. When it comes to the king, do you have to make him a total moron?
Happy if their king is happy. Let me show you. Greetings, my gleeful subjects.
Yeah. Okay, the audience reactions are also a bit funny. Yeah.
Old friend Marco Diaz seems to think you're not having a good time, and I said that's impossible. Of course you're having a good time.
Not really.
Are you not lifted?
I'm trying to enjoy it, okay? As much as I can.
How's about you lift some of this garbage out of the streets?
What that stuff is? I thought you were all having a garage sale.
What are you going to do about the burning
building? Did you look at that?
Oh, you have to let one burn every once in a while. How else will you have room?
Yeah, why not? Why not burn another one to make even more space? What the fuck?
There's no monster in the corn.
Okay, here we have the monster.
Well, I'll be dipped.
Marco.
I'll be able to take care of that. Hey, you there! Move along!
Move! Monsters. It's not having it. Okay, you want me? You want me to come over, yeah? Okay, here I come.
She'll never make it past the magic shield. There's still the moat. Yes, she'll never make it across the magic moat.
Yeah, that was that. How many magical barriers do you have here? So yeah, these little jokes are funny, but overall the whole plot
is right. I'm not
is not interesting to me. And it makes the king less likable. I liked him more before than before this episode.
Hey! You locked me out.
I mean, I understand it. He's a character that can still grow, and I hope he will in the future.
Okay.
A bit.
Unlock the door.
I can't do anything.
Maybe you're like, oh, I do enjoy dumbass characters who are just stupid, but yeah.
Hey, pull yourself
Star
together,
already
man.
Acts stupid sometimes.
You should never have left me in charge.
Ludo does.
The people love you, she said. Keep them happy and safe, she said. And now, because of me, the kingdom is defenseless. Moon didn't even tell me where she was taking Star. What if something happened to them? No wonder I want to party all the time. I'm worried sick.
Yeah. Okay, here we have the reason why he partied so much. I do understand, but still.
It's funny you should ask, Marco. Let me show you something. Whenever Moon goes away, she always puts together a few outfits for me. So I know what to wear while she's gone.
Yeah, she puts you the exact same outfit.
all the way together. To the top of the room. So it's probably she's not coming back anytime soon.
I don't know, but they can't ever come home.
He sounded also more intelligent when he was younger. And now.
Oh, right, yes. I see what you're saying. This is the end of everything.
No, this is just the end of good script writing and making characters likable and interesting. But carry on.
They hated me before.
It doesn't matter. You're the only king they have.
You sound just what I need.
That's the reason why they should have a dumb king. Because he's the only one.
We are. Okay, I deserve that. Look. If the queen were here,
that's not a very valid argument in my eyes.
Well, she's not here, but that doesn't mean we should cower in fear. We still have each other, and together, we can defeat this monster.
No offense, king, but you're a terrible king.
You're right. I stink at this, but right now I'm all you've got, and you're all I've got.
So you have to take me.
Wait,
if I would be the people, I would like. Down with the king, get another one!
Don't need magic to do extraordinary things! Dentist, construction worker, remember when you two worked together to dislodge...
Well, she wears glasses, really, and construction worker has actually construction clothes?
The turtle sanctuary to make iron.
Is this supposed to be funny? Because I find it rather weird.
And you two weirdos hold the record for the longest daring contest!
What?
Woohoo!
Oh, man, I lost! We all can do something unique and helpful, and that's Mewni's greatest strength. And it's what Queen Moon loves the most about all of you.
Yeah, we all bring her pretty good. I don't think any of that's gonna help us defeat the monster.
Yeah.
So, what do you say? Let's show that monster what happens when it messes with humans! Fulduk, fetch us our loincloths.
What?
He's near.
Yeah, you. He's right there.
Yeah, there he is.
What, hey, boy, monster!
He?
Go away!
Go away? But you're the one who called me over.
What? I didn't call you over.
Oh.
Yes, you did. You kept motioning, come here, come here.
Oh, no, I was motioning, go away, go away.
Oh, no, that's come here, come here.
No, it's go away, go away.
Is this Kevin Michael Richardson again as a monster? I guess so.
This way for nothing.
Love his voice.
I got like 1,000 splinters on his foot.
Help.
You might consider widening the streets a little.
Okay, goodbye. There goes one citizen. And thus, problem solved. Okay, that was actually funny, I think. That he could talk it out with a monster. Like, it was a misunderstanding. But don't use that joke again, it just works one time.
Hip, hooray!
She's a princess winning battles through the break of dawn.
This ending has such a Sailor Moon vibe to it. Or anime vibe to it. I know animes who have a bit like music that is kind of the same. I think it's cool, I like it. I like it a lot. Also, it's a nice view here of Mewni. Whole day and then sun goes down. But I also have to say that I liked the first opening better. I found it so much fun. It was just... I loved the song. And I like this song, I like this outro. Did I say opening? I mean, outro. yeah. First one I thought was a little bit better. But I'm all for some change, so it's okay that it changed. And it changed. It could have been much worse. I do like it. That's actually good. So, yeah. So, as you clearly saw, first episode, The whole, yeah, I have to write in a book thing went on forever, and it's just not my thing. It was just way too long for me, and so this episode is a little bit like, for me. And then the second episode, you clearly saw that the king being a total stupid fool for the whole time is not really my thing. Yeah, and you saw that I still could enjoy this episode a bit. I hope that's okay. So, yeah, that's the best reaction I could give you guys. Next episodes will have more laughs and more likable moments for me personally to enjoy. That I can say. So, yeah, if you like this video, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe and stuff like that. I already talked about this, so yeah. See you next time. This is Andy saying goodbye, take care, and see you on the other side. Bye.